All right, hello everyone. I'm going to paper trade. So if you look at the bottom, this is simulated trading, TradingView paper trading for the next 1 hour and 10 minutes. Hello everyone.
Hello, everyone. Hello, everyone. All right.
Hello everyone and welcome. In this video I want to talk about first principles of ICT trading. I want to talk about the framework, the principles of understanding the market and how you need to approach it if you want to be an ICT trader. Okay. First off, before I get into it guys, I want to give credit to this guy right here, Michael, Inner Circle Trader. I did not come up with these ideas myself, guy. These are all the theories and the workings of Michael Huddleston. So, and by the way, I'm not going to relay all of his information perfectly to you, so you need to go and do your own research. With that being said, let's get to the chart and let's talk about first principles. So, we're here on the ES, and I'm not going to try and spend too much time on this video, but we'll get right into it. The basic premise of understanding ICT is that the market is driven, controlled by artificial intelligence, okay? That the market has been automated, all right? And now, what does that mean? It means that the algorithm or the automation in the market is performing a set of commands in order to achieve something. Now, if you accept that the market, as in the S&P 500, the Dow Jones, the NASDAQ, Russell 2000, most of the futures markets, if you accept that they are driven by Hello everyone and welcome. Alright, you saw me trade paper trading for a $1,530 profit. TradingView paper trading. I'll show you the executions. 1 minute chart. Did take a pretty substantial loss here on a short. I think that was pretty obviously a mistake. I was seeing that it was respecting that green candle. I was kind of missing the bigger picture, though, and that we'd come down to an inefficiency. And so I was kind of missing the bigger picture there. And it ended up pretty quickly taking a loss on that. So that was like a $1,500 loss. But nevertheless, we came back. So had I missed out on that, or had I not taken that particular short down at 901, we'd be up 3K on the lunch session, trading three contracts. So overall, the two trades that I messed up, I was longing this, and I could have put the stop further, and that would have been fine. Or I could have just gotten out of the trade as I saw that, like, you know, this happened pretty unexpectedly. They pushed into stops here. So I was long here, and then you can see that they pushed into stops below these short-term lows, then ripped higher, right? Yes, they are coming after your stop. So they did that, and I ended up taking a pretty bad loss on that. And then I thought the market was that green candle was respecting that green candle, so I got short here and I took a loss on that. So every other trade was a profit. Every single other trade was a profit. Those were the two losses. We were just following the market up. You could see that as the market was trading higher, I was following it, just taking these short and sweet scalps. As I saw that the market would trade below these green candles, we'd get short. So did take a couple shorts in there, believe it or not, even though obviously the market is trading higher. And then as the market went up, we were just following it. Following at night, so that was a 6-point trade. We were following it here. We bought, sold, covered. So sold three here. And that entry could have even been better. But basically the idea was, okay, I saw that we traded below that green candle, and we were trading below the mean threshold of that black candle. So as I saw that we did that, I figured, all right, we're probably coming down one standard deviation, which we did. And I would have been filled on my original profit target, so missed out on some profit there. It's not perfect, but it's pretty good day trading. I'll just review the mistakes. So here on this buy, it's hard for me to call that a mistake. Like, the market definitely looked like it was right then about to push into these equal highs. That being said, really, unfortunately, the stop needed to come all the way down here to allow for this sort of push into stops that they did here. Or I could have similarly, right, put my stop right there, been stopped out, and then re-entered long. And that's probably what I should have done. So got long there at 91. The stop should have been at 84. Okay. So the stop should there have been at 84. And then been stopped out and re-entered long. On this loss here, when I shorted at 901s, I see why I did it, right? I was respecting that green candle. The stop should have been right there. You wouldn't want to see, you know, you would want to see the market close there and then immediately go lower. You really wouldn't want to see it come above that first green candle. And it did that pretty quickly, so I widened the stop too much on that one. And then refining some of the exits a little bit, like there, when I sold short three and I covered two right there. As I saw the market was making a little bit of a reaction on those black candles, I could have held on to that a little bit longer. The second exit was good at 923 three quarters. That was pretty close to the low. The low was at 920. But that was a little bit premature for me to release two there, but nevertheless. All right, this has been paper trading the New York lunch session on a 1 minute chart. And then I reviewed some of my errors. This is all using ICT order flow, guys. I had no idea where the market was going for any long period of time. I was just following ICT order flow. That's it, just order flow scalping. Bye.